Dr. Duke Majan, and I'm here with one of my patients who just finished having the Duke laser disc repair, endoscopic laser-assisted repair of two herniated discs in his back. And we finished about an hour ago. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling great. I'm feeling much better. Yeah.
Good. And a few minutes ago, we were chatting about your symptoms, and you said that you would have a Charlie horse in your leg. Tell me about that.
So, you know, after the pain that was in my leg, as I would do any morning stretch, just you wake up in the morning and you just reach and you stretch out your body, and immediately I would feel a Charlie horse pain throughout the right leg, consistently every day. And just to test it out, just to feel what that would be like, I just flexed that calf and kind of simulate that, and nothing at all.
So the leg pain is gone?
Gone.
And then what about the pain in your lower back there? Do you still have that pain?
That pain is gone.
Cured? Yeah.
Cured, completely.
Awesome. I know you're a little sore from the surgery.
Yeah.
So why did you decide to do the Duke laser disc repair as opposed to a fusion or something more invasive like that?
Well, my physician recommended me actually to get to send me to a place that I will not name, but to get a fusion surgery. And we looked into reviews and whatnot, and my wife, God bless her, she said, let's look elsewhere and look for places with the right kind of reviews. This was the first place that showed up with the best reviews. So we immediately had that consultation with you, and everything that you said about laser disc repair and what it would do was exactly what we wanted.
Good. Yeah, I can't tell you how many times I hear that story about the spouse saving the day and doing the research. So what's it like for your wife who has to live with you being in pain? You're such a healthy guy. You're really active in the community. You've got students, you're a musician. I mean, what's it like having to deal with, you know, seeing you and your quality of life basically robbed from the back and leg pain? What is that like for her, do you think?
That's tough, because she's already a mother of two, and just being a caretaker and having to step up and do all the things that two parents need to be doing at home on her own on days where I can't move or I can't function because the pain is so bad. It can be really stressful, because it takes two. And so now that we'll be able to do this together again, it's going to be amazing.
You will, but you have to let your back heal so we don't re-injure it, right?
That's correct. Yes, absolutely.
But washing dishes, no problem.
you can
start tomorrow.
We get full laundry and everything.
Yesterday. Yeah. I mean, you know, one thing that chronic pain does is it literally robs people of their dignity. And I think that's the best way to say it, because human beings are social creatures, and we interact, we work together, we collaborate together, we assist each other, and we all work towards common goals. And when you're married or you have kids, you have other people dependent on you, you really, if you're in pain all the time and you can't be active, you're always psychologically you're down, physically you're down, and you don't want your kids seeing you in pain and suffering. So sometimes it's easier just to take a back seat, and that's not how you want your children remembering you.
Right.
So this is, back pain's a deep thing. A lot of people don't understand it. They just think it's pain on the surface, but it really goes deep into interpersonal relationships and dignity.
Absolutely. Yeah, one of the things, best advice I ever got was, it's not always 50-50, and sometimes it stretches in your marriage, that 80-20 and whatnot, and back and forth. And for the next year, it's gonna be leaning heavily on my wife, but I know that after that, I'm gonna be able to get on the floor with my boys. I'm gonna be able to throw the ball around with them, and I'm gonna be able to take them to wherever they wanna go and play at the park with them, and I can't wait.
Good for you.
Yeah.
So tell me just a little bit about your being a musician, and what are you looking forward to being able to do? Now, don't say lift the piano, whatever you do, okay?
right.
Because we know that's how all this started 6 years ago.
Yes.
But what are you looking forward to? How did this pain affect your job, your passion, your love for music?
I'm on my feet sometimes 12 to 14 hours at a day. And within a few hours of just being on my feet, I can feel that pain. And knowing that I can go through a full day and being able to function properly, being able to pick up my saxophone and play comfortably without having to worry about any pain, it means the world to me.
Yeah, it sure does. I mean, as a musician, you're totally focused on playing that piece. You put everything into it. You got the music going. You got to keep up. You have the right tempo, the rhythm, and pain can be a massive distraction, right?
I have an anecdote of that. I mean, I'm sitting in a rehearsal playing and having to make sure that my brain becomes more focused on how I was sitting constantly to keep the pain away so I could play. And and now I can focus on the more important things, which is the music making.
That's wonderful. We call that fear avoidance behavior. And what it means is moving a certain way, doing a certain thing, you're afraid. You have fear of doing that because you know it's going to bring on the pain. And so your focus, part of your brain's just focused on avoid the pain by avoiding certain movements. It's a distraction.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. And I look forward to not having to think about that again.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you so much for everything.
You're welcome. My pleasure.